Welcome to the Anxiety Attic, where I make self-help videos for anxiety disorders. Tachycardia is a scary word. You may have heard it in medical dramas, or just come across it when Googling your symptoms. Maybe you were taken to hospital, and they mentioned tachycardia when they put you on a monitor. Yet they just sent you home telling you it was just anxiety or a panic attack. But surely if you were tachycardic, there must be something seriously wrong. So in this video, I'm going to help you understand the difference between tachycardia and panic attacks, and cover some of the things that you may be worrying about. I should of course point out that I'm not a doctor. My area of expertise is anxiety. So if you are having unexplained heart symptoms and haven't been checked out by a doctor, then you should. So what is tachycardia? Tachycardia simply means a fast heart rate. Anything over 100 is considered tachycardia. The problem is, when people with anxiety Google tachycardia, they find all sorts of other scary words like superventricular tachycardia, atrial fibrillation, or ventricular fibrillation. And some of these can indicate serious heart problems, which may need treatment. But most causes of tachycardia are much less dramatic. Exercise can make your heart go over 100, which is completely normal and healthy. High intake of caffeine can cause tachycardia. In fact, I gave up caffeine completely 16 years ago, as it would cause me to have both a fast and irregular heartbeat. Some medications can cause tachycardia, as can illegal drugs like amphetamines or cocaine. Some medical problems like overactive thyroid or anemia can cause tachycardia. Fever can also cause tachycardia. But note, if you suffer from panic attacks, don't confuse hot flushes with fever. It's normal for body temperature to rise when you have a panic attack, and I have a whole video on this subject, which I have linked above. But the most common cause of tachycardia is anxiety or panic attacks. When you're in danger, your heart speeds up to help you run from or fight the danger. This is completely normal. A panic attack occurs when your body goes into this fight or flight state without any apparent danger. But this is not a problem of the heart or body. It's a problem of the mind, and is quite treatable, which I will talk more about later. So how do you know if your episodes of tachycardia are caused by a serious heart problem, or by anxiety or panic disorder? Well, only a doctor can tell you that, but I will give you some pointers. Have a look at these two lists. Pause the video to read each list carefully. If list 1 sounds like you, then your tachycardia episodes are more likely to have a physical cause, so you should be and probably are already talking to a doctor. If list 2 sounds more like you, then the cause of your episodes of tachycardia is more likely to be psychological. So the best thing you can do is, instead of spending lots of time learning everything you can about the many different types of heart problems, focus your efforts on treating your anxiety. And the best treatment for anxiety and panic attacks is cognitive behavioral therapy. This is best done with a therapist, but if you can't afford or access therapy, have a look at my 8 video series on panic disorder. It teaches you the causes of panic attacks, how to deal with them, and how to reduce or stop them altogether. Here's a link to the first video. But if it's not a fast heart rate that you're worried about, but skip beats or extra beats, then you might find this video on ectopic heartbeats and anxiety of interest.